Why are you disturbing me? I gave you the power, I gave you the authority. I said you will decree a thing and it shall be established unto you. I told you that wheresoever the sole of your foot shall tread upon shall be given you as a possession. I told you that these signs will follow them that believe. In my name, you will cast out devils. You will speak with new tongues. If you lay hands upon the sick, they will recover. Why are you disturbing me? Why are you disturbing me? Why are you disturbing me? And God said to Moses, lift up your rod. He lifted it up. God then said, point it to the water. He did, and what happened? It parted. It parted. What happened? That is what the psalmist is referring to here. That's what he's referring to here. He said, when Israel went out of Egypt, the house of Jacob, from a people of strange language, Judah was his sanctuary, and Israel his dominion. The sea saw it and fled. Every sea before you is fleeing. You know what happened is the glory of God showed up. And as soon when Moses lifted up the rod and then pointed to the water, the glory of God showed up all of a sudden. And what happened? Immediately, without any wasting of time, the sea parted hither and thither. And then Israel went through. In the name of Jesus, you are going through. By the power of the Lord, you are going through. Every obstacle on your way, every obstruction on your path, the Lord will clear them up in Jesus' name. Now it was the time of Joshua. And Joshua now got to the bank of Jordan. And God told Joshua, if you are going to cross this Jordan, if you are going to cross this problem, on one condition, sanctify yourself. Holiness, purity, righteousness. If you are going to overcome the enemy of your life, if you are going to be able to run the race effectively, successfully to the end, holiness, purity, righteousness, uprightness, sanctify yourself, and then appoint the elders. That is why we expect people in the church that are elders in the church and leaders in the church to lead by example. Let each one pick a stone, and it's a stone of memorial. There are ways you live your life, there are sacrifices you make in life that will be a memorial for others to follow, that will help them to run the race effectively to the end. And then as they were going, they got there right now, going by the instruction of the Lord, Jordan saw it, and then what did he do? Fled. That's what the Bible says, and Jordan was driven back. Now, this same Joshua, of course, they knew when they left Egypt, the pillar of cloud was with them. The pillar of fire was with them. But at this point in time, the pillar is no more. And Joshua thought, now that the pillar is no more, we need to strengthen our hands. No, you will not fight in this battle. Did you hear what I just said? You will not fight in this battle. Whose battle is it? It's the Lord's battle. It's the Lord's battle. He will win for you in Jesus' name. That's why you should be courageous that you will make it to the end. You make it to the end. And so, at this time, Joshua was there. And then while he was there, the Lord showed up. He saw a man all over him. And then, courageously he went, are you for us or you are for our enemy, for our adversary? And he said, I am come as the captain of the host of the Lord. Who is this captain of the host of the Lord? Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. All through the time they left Egypt, he was there with them. The rock in the wilderness that was struck, that brought out water. Who was the rock? Jesus. He was there. And the Lord will continue to be with us in Jesus' name. Tell somebody, God is with you. I didn't get that one. I said, tell the other person, God is with you. Amen. And now tell somebody confidently, God is with me. If God be for us, there is nothing the enemy can do to you. Don't be afraid. That's where many people are falling, because they are not sure of the companionship of the Lord. Now, another thing, see from this passage that we read. The angel, the captain that came like an angel, which is Christ himself, he said, take off your shoe. Because the ground where you are is what? It's a holy ground. Why is it? Because the Lord himself is there. When he met with Moses in the wilderness, and then the bush was burning, the voice came, Moses, take off your shoe, because the ground where you are is what? Holy ground. This is where I am going. God in person was coming that time. Right now, where is God? I said, this is just a quick test for you now. Where is God right now? Inside of you, that means anywhere I go is a holy ground. Anywhere I enter becomes holy, because I am pregnant of God. I am carrying God. Everywhere I go, victory is following in the name of Jesus. That is why every day of your life must be a holy life, a righteous life. You don't want to grieve the spirit of the Lord. You don't want to wait until you come to church. You know why this church is a holy place? It's because there are holy people here carrying the holy God on the inside of them. Who is carrying God right here? Because he tells us, I will live in them. Amen. And that is why you are victorious. That is why you are victorious, and the Lord will keep you to the end in Jesus' name. Moses made it. Elijah made it. Elijah saw walk with God despite what happened. That God sent angels to Elijah to come and transport him home with chariots of fire. You know why it was chariots of fire? So that nothing around will be able to hinder the flow of the moon. They are angels of fire. Angels of fire. And I'm here to let you know that the angels of the Lord, they encamp round about them that fear the Lord. You are not alone. I say you are not alone. The Lord will keep you. The Lord will preserve you. That is why over here, when we say this is sin, that is sin, stay away from me. When you read from the word of God, stay away from me, because you want the presence of God. You want the companionship of the Holy Spirit in your life. You want the guidance of the Holy God of heaven. You want someone that will fight the battle for you. Moses did not have to do anything to cross the Red Sea. God did it. Joshua crossed Jordan. God did it. Even the battle of Jericho, all they did was just march around, march around, march around, march around. And eventually, God in his power sent invisible army inside the city. Amen. Amen. This is what happened. Let me tell you. There is a combination of physical and invisible things that happened. As they were circling that wall, is an indication, amen, of God collapsing the wall. At the final shout that they were told to shout on the seventh day and the last march, that shout is a shout of jubilation. It's a shout of victory. And what is our shout of victory today? Oh, you are not sure. That's why you are here. I say, what's our shout of victory today? Will you shout and let me hear you? Will you shout and let me hear you? Will you shout and let me hear you? Hallelujah! 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 Amen! It is well. It is well. I feel like I'm almost in heaven already. Because those of you under the sound of my voice, together we are making it. The three Hebrews made it. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, despite the circumstances surrounding them, you will make it. Daniel made it, you will make it. Look at even Elisha. Even after Elisha was dead, The power of God was still with him. You know, the little children, when we are in the children class, we tell them, show me your power. And they do like this. You remember? Children teacher, you remember? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And I don't know, because our power is Christ Jesus, I don't know I can tell you to demonstrate your power. Amen. But all I can tell you to do is to just shout that name.
Jesus.
I can't hear somebody.
Jesus.
Jesus. At the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Is Lord. Listen, right there where you are, I can tell you I don't have enough time, that I will just get into a place and some strange personalities will be there. How do I know? Because of what happened. And somebody not talking, not preaching, not praying, and somebody just sighting will begin to scream and shout. Until they take the person out, because before we'll be okay. And so, God is there with you. Amen. And anywhere you get to, if there is anything contrary, the power of God will knock them out in Jesus' name. Even after the death of Elisha, the carcasses of Elisha, the rotting bone of Elisha, the power of God that was there when he was alive was there with him in the grave. They threw a dead man into that graveyard of Elisha. As soon as the body touched the bone of Elisha, what happened to the person? He woke up. Life is coming back to you. In the name of Jesus. Very quickly, I get to the final part, combating the forces of fear. Combating the forces of fear. Isaiah chapter 35 verse 4. Isaiah chapter 35 verse 4. It says, say to them that of a fearful heart, be strong, fear not, behold, your God will come. And when he comes, he will come with vengeance. Even God with a recompense, he will come and save you. All those that have afflicted you shall be afflicted. All those that have tormented you shall be tormented. All those that have troubled you, the Lord will trouble them in Jesus' name. The Lord is with you. The Lord will walk with you. The Lord will strengthen you. The Lord will keep you in the name of Jesus. Now, when the Bible says he will come with vengeance, let me show you something from the Bible. Are you ready? Are you ready? What I just want to show you very quickly what will become of your enemy. That's why you should not be afraid of running this race, of running it in righteousness and purity and holiness. You know, the Bible says that the righteous shall be as bold as lion. Bold as lion. All that God needs to see is just righteousness and holiness, and then he fights for you. He fights for you. Open your Bible to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah, because we have been told in Isaiah 35, 4, that your God will come with vengeance, with recompense. He will come to save you. When he comes to save you, understand that the enemy has taken grip of you. Now God is coming to save you. For him to save you, what is going to happen to your enemy? Are you there? Chapter 29. Look at verse 6. Look at the verse 6. Now, please, for goodness sake, don't read this one to your fellow brother. Don't read it to your fellow sister. Amen. This is meant for the enemy of your soul. Praise the Lord. Are you there? Isaiah 29, if I were you, I will mark this in my Bible. Okay, shall we look at it? It says, thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts. With what? With what? To who? I said to who? Your enemy. He's saying, your enemy, my enemy, our enemy, the enemy of the Lord shall be visited of the Lord of hosts with thunder and with earthquake and with great noise and with storm and with tempest and the flame of devouring. Your enemies are devoured. Your enemies are devoured. All that are incensed against you shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. So, if we are going to overcome this enemy, Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10, it says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Tell somebody next to you, fear not. I love my brother. He said it with smile and with conviction. I said, tell somebody, fear not. Amen. Because God will help you. No matter what you are going through, God will help you. It says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Verse 11. It says, behold. Behold. Who is God talking to here? I think it's me. He says, behold, all they that were incensed against thee shall be ashamed and confounded. Ye shall be as nothing. And they that strive with thee shall perish. That is the word of the Lord. For you to be able to make it to the end in Jesus' name. You know, God is saying to me to tell you through his word. Through his word, that all those things that have made you to be fidgeting, fearful, panicking, God is saying that the time has come. You will even look for them, you will not find them. Look at the next verse. Look at the next verse. What is the next verse? Tell me. Amen. Amen. That is the word of the Lord for you. And it will come to pass in Jesus' name. Amen. Verse 12, thou shalt seek them and shalt not find them. Even them that contended with thee, they that war against thee shall be as nothing and as a thing of naught. That will come to pass in your life in Jesus' name. And if that is the case, what do we need to combat the enemy? We need personal experience of salvation. Personal experience. It's not just we are saved. No, I am saved. When somebody is asking you, are you born again? What's your answer? I think so. No, not me. I'm not thinking about it. I'm fully convinced within me, fully persuaded within me that I am born again. I'm born again. Personal experience of salvation. Number two, exceeding promises of God. Promises of God. You know, the Bible tells us in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4. And I really want you to get there, but for lack of time, I can't wait for you. Say, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by this ye might be partakers of divine nature. Divine nature. Divine nature. We need the precious promises of God. Number three, we need extended period of prayer. Jesus said, without me, you can do how many things? We need the power of prayer. That's why we are told to pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. You need the power of prayer. You know, please let me challenge you here. You know, sometimes I hear some people that are not even holiness church like us, they say they have a prayer line. And then you log into that prayer line and you see thousands of people there. But you know, we that says we are the children of God and we are men and women of the world, when we call for prayer, we don't see us. We don't see us. From now on, we will see you. We need prayer. That is why over here, you had the announcement earlier on. Every blessed month, we have prayer and fasting in this church. And that's why things are working right for us. And things will work right for you in Jesus' name. Every blessed month, we have night vigil in this church. In this church. And we've been doing this for years and years and years. By the grace of God. Every blessed week of the month. And every month of the year. And every year that we witness, listen, from Monday to Thursday, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. is for prayer in this church. Every blessed day. Monday to Thursday. We've been doing that for years. Because we can do nothing without him. And that's of Monday to Thursday. You can be in Baltimore and log in. You can be at New York and log in. Even people from California that is 6 hours away, they log in. They wait for that moment of time. People from Texas, they log in. People from Ohio, they log in. You know people that don't log in? People that don't believe in prayer. Ask your neighbor. Is he talking about you? You know the pastors that don't log in. Pastors that don't believe in prayer. They believe in the arm of the flesh. I can do it alone. Self-confidence. Self-confidence. I am here to tell you there is nothing I've ever accomplished in life without the help and the grace of God. And the power of prayer. The power of prayer. Many of us, if we say we are having prayer retreat now, come. And then we say we are going to start 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. It's like, is God that difficult? Amen. But we need prayer. And God will help us in Jesus' name. You say, Pastor, how can I get involved with this prayer you are talking about? It's very easy. Get your pen and paper. I know you have pen already. I know you have paper already. You are ready to write the number down? The prayer line. I give it unto you. I'm waiting for you. Can I continue? 712-432-3100. I repeat that number. 712-432-3100. And the access code is 280-706. 280-706. And those of you that have been logging in, you know, from time to time, people come with testimony. When they come with their prayer requests, and then we pray. Later, they come and said, I asked for this, and God has done it. Your miracle is coming your way in Jesus' name. So we need prayer, not just a nominal prayer, a real, real prayer, serious prayer. Then we need prayer partners. Somebody say prayer partner. We need prayer partners. Sometimes you need someone that can lift up your spirit, join hands with you, agree with you. If the two of you shall agree together as touching anything, it shall be done of my Father which is in heaven. That prayer partner may not be somebody who is in another world or another planet. You know what I'm talking about? It can be as close as your spouse, your husband, your wife. Can be as close as your sibling. Can be as close as your parent. Can be as close as your children. A prayer partner. Somebody that is going to work with. You know, sometimes some people, they say they are praying, but in reality, they are in fear. A and B are in fear together. And fear plus fear is equal to what? Fear plus. Amen. But when you are in faith and I'm in faith, things will happen in Jesus' name. We need to overcome the enemy. We need enthusiastic purpose of heart, purpose in mind. That's why Paul said, I am fully persuaded. We need to eliminate the strongholds of the enemy. Whatever the stronghold may be, yours may be different from mine. Eliminate everything and it will be well with you. We need something called endowment of power from on high. Endowment of power from on high. It is this power that makes things work instantaneously. It is this power of the Lord that makes things easy for you to do. Power from on high is coming. I said it's coming. I said it's coming. In the name of Jesus, finally, you need the gospel of salvation. Salvation, the gospel, be a preacher, preach the word. There is nothing more we need than all this. And with this, Victory is sure in Jesus' name. As you watch over others, you watch over yourself. As you commit yourself to the Lord is committed unto you. And every plot and plan of the enemy, the power of God will destroy in Jesus' name. It is time for us to pray. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. If you don't mind rising on your feet, you don't want to fall by the wayside. You don't want to be like Saul that started well. Started with the prophet of God. Started in the will of God. Started with appointment and approval of God. But ended with the witch at Endor. He died a miserable death. Tell the Lord to keep you through. Tell the Lord to help you through. Every impediment on your way, every problem on your way, tell the Lord to remove and destroy them. This is your session, this is your time. If there is any sin in your life, repent of it, renounce it, confess it unto God, and God will help you. Sin cannot enter heaven. Sin will not enter heaven. Say in the name of Jesus, I will not fall by the wayside. I will not be in the number of fallen soldiers. Hey, I will not be a wounded soldier. I will follow through to the end. Keep me through, Lord Jesus, keep me through. There is a race I must run. You don't want the enemy to rejoice over you. You don't want the devil to rejoice over you. The unbelievers you have preached to, you don't want them to rejoice over you. You don't want to diminish the kingdom of God. After you have escaped the pollution of the world, you don't want to be entrapped by it again. How are the mighty falling? In the midst of the battle and the weapons of war perish. That will not be your portion, that will not be my portion. Examine yourself, examine your life. If you are here, you have not even started the journey, you are not born again yet. Why don't you say, Lord Jesus, I give myself to you, I give my life unto you. Save me now. Save me from sin. The soul that sinneth is shall die. You were created for a purpose. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. At this point, I want to give everybody equal opportunity of finding favor and grace in the sight of the Lord. Equal opportunity of obtaining mercy from the throne of grace. Equal of opportunity of getting re-enlisted in this race. Opportunity of divine sustenance to run to the very end. All eyes closed. All eyes closed. You are before the throne of God, the Lord Almighty. You have heard the word of God. And you know yourself that if death should come now because of the way things are, you will not make it. But you are saying today, Lord Jesus, remember me for good. Maybe you were saved before, but some things have happened and your focus is shifted from the cross. Your focus is shifted from God, from heaven. But you are saying, Lord, today I repent in dust and ashes. I'm returning home. If you're here today like that, you want restoration of your faith back unto you. If you raise up your hand, I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You are not raising up unto me. It's unto the Lord. Some people don't understand why I say raise up your hand. I told you about Moses. Moses was told, point the rod to heaven before pointing to the sea. Generally, I say, raise up your hand. You are pointing to God. And then I say, lay it upon yourself. People don't understand the spiritual implication of what they are doing. They think it's just a ritual. No, no. Yes, thank you, those of you with your hands up. Raise it up very well. As if you are really, really, really serious with what you are doing. I thank God for those of you. I bless the name of the Lord for you. Now is the accepted time. Today is your day of salvation. All those hands that are up, before you put them down, please keep it up. You are here today. You are not born again yet. But you want to give your life to Jesus. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. And you are saying, Lord Jesus, I give my life to you. Join them. Raise up your hand. Raise up your hand. We are not going to do that separately. God bless you. God bless you. Keep it up. Now, all those that their hands are up, lay that hand upon your chest. Lay it upon your chest. Because it's between you and God, that's why I said people should close their eyes. Lay it upon your chest. Please lay that hand upon your chest. Lay it upon your chest. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Now quietly. 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 The person next to you must not hear what you are saying. Repent of those things you know that are like impediments on your way, that are like obstacles on your path. The things you know the enemy is wanting to use to distract you, to deter you, to deprive you of heaven, to deny you of your blessing. Just check the Lord about them. Repent of them. Confess them to the Lord right now. If you will believe with your heart and confess with your mouth, you will be saved. Come unto me, O ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will give you rest. For God sent his Son to the world for such a sinner as you. Every sin is a transgression of the law. In Jesus' name we pray. Keep your hand on yourself. I want to pray for you. Father, I bless you for this moment and for this hour. I thank you for all my brothers and sisters in the faith right now that have examined themselves, acknowledged their sins, confessed unto you their fault, their error, their transgression, asking for mercy, asking for pardon, asking for favor from you. Holy Ghost, I pray that in the name of Jesus, look down from heaven, O Lord, upon these humble people. Forgive their iniquities in Jesus' name. In whatsoever way they have transgressed your law, Father, forgive in Jesus' name. even those that are newly giving their lives unto you for the very first time. You said, any man that will come unto me, I will not cast away for whatsoever reason. Oh Lord, receive them unto yourself in Jesus' name. Wash them clean with the blood of Jesus. Set them free from the power of guilt and condemnation. I pray, Lord, that from today, their names be written in the book of life in Jesus' name. Every plot of the enemy, every plan of the devil concerning them, cancel right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for answering. For in Jesus' name we pray. Put your hands together for the Lord. Put your hands together for the Lord. If you are really happy, if you are really joyful, that people are reconciling with God, that people are returning to the Lord, is that the best you can do for His glory? If angels in heaven are happy, why not you? Why not you? Why not you? Amen. Amen. Now I want to pray for everybody in the house, so that you will not fall by the wayside, so that you will not be a failure in life. Close your eyes and let us pray. Father, we thank you for this great call with which you have called us unto yourself. The call with which you have called us into the fold, into the family of God, the family of holiness, the family of righteousness, the family of purity and uprightness, the family of faith. Oh Lord, oh God, we have laid our hands upon the plow. We declare today that in the name of Jesus, no turning back. No turning back. No turning back. Every plot of the enemy, every plan of the enemy to sidetrack us, to deceive us, to deny us of our right. Oh Lord, oh God, we cancel them now in Jesus' name. Any form of attack of the enemy on our life, oh Lord, on our family, on our spouses and children, on our parents as well, on our fellow members, our leaders, and Lord God, the members of the church, we come against them in unity right now. We destroy every works of darkness, every power of the enemy now in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, oh God, as many that have been attacked with sickness, with infirmity, with affliction, with torment, with oppression, with depression, I come against every tool and the activities of the enemy in the life of everyone. Oh God, destroy them right now in Jesus' name. Whoever is the agent of darkness that the enemy is trying to use to destroy our vision and goal, oh Lord, oh God, we pray, thunder from heaven, thunder from heaven, destroy them in Jesus' name, devouring fire, destroy them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Glory be to your holy name. All hands that are feeble, strengthen them. Strengthen them. Everyone that is contemplating going back to Egypt, Holy Ghost, hinder them in Jesus' name. Every source of discouragement, Lord, take away from your church, from your people, from our lives in Jesus' name. Visit us afresh. Do something new. The joy of salvation. Father, rekindle in our soul in Jesus' name. When we get to the top, we will see one another. We'll rejoice with one another. We'll embrace one another. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Turn to someone and say, I will meet you on the top. I will meet you on the top. You will meet me on the top. Together we shall get to the top. In the name of Jesus. Thank you so much. God bless you. Amen. Now, we are going to go to the last message for the retreat as we